We're going now to the festival town, which is called Zaandam, and this is like almost part of Amsterdam, like it's just right next to it in the north. And this is where the festival will be. It's like 15 minutes from here. And this location got used a couple of times for festivals as well, but not for a techno festival. I think we were the first one. Here is the entrance. So this is the back of the stage. I saw this yesterday for the first time in real life, and then I was like, oh, whoa, this is serious, you know? So we're here at the festival site. It's basically like less than 24 hours before everything is starting. There's so many people working on this, and a lot of people don't realize this, but normally where we're standing is like a parking spot. And everything that you see here, like the stage and all the bars and everything around it, has to be built up in a short amount of time. I think they started beginning this week. So it's super intense. And yeah, also the sound guys, the technicians, the lights, there will be lasers everywhere, fire, CO2. This all has to be built up and checked that it's safe. The sound plan here, as you can see, there's like, it's called line arrays. They have like the speakers next to the stage. We have here another left-right set. And in the back, so like everywhere you stand, you will have you have great sound. And in front there's like 24 double subwoofers. This is basically more than enough to make the whole field shake. I was really happy. I was talking with the sound guy before, and he explained me what we have here, and it was actually a bit more than planned. I also told him that for me the sound is like super important. It's the main thing on the festival, and they did an amazing job. So I'm gonna connect my stuff in a bit and then make it shake. Hey, so I'm just going to do my sound check here. We have everything set up and time to check out if it works. So this controls basically the 909. So what you hear now when I push this button, you have a kick, snare, some toms, hi-hat, and I can get started here. I can, for example, take one of my favorite kicks for myself. It's a kick and bass, this one, very powerful. Now is because the sun is on here, you can barely read the screen. So I'm actually trying to find something for tomorrow to block the sun out. Otherwise you have to memorize this all. It's super annoying if you have complex patterns. Okay, so we have here the first technical problem is that there's no sound coming out of the 101 for some reason. And then you're also going to check what can it be. It's probably something with the notes going from here to there. Not going right. Should be the output or the 101 is broken. But we have two more laying around. this is definitely the 101. Ik vraag of ze die spare 101 kunnen pakken, want deze is kapot.
Oh, dit is nu ook kapot.
Ja. Yeah. Oh, it's good that we do a sound check because this thing is broken. Ja. Yeah. Oké, okay, niks gezegd. Ja, goed. In this way you're like also able to do like live remixes of existing tracks. This is like Universal Nation, a remix from Bart Skills on my label. And then I just put a sequence on top and change, put extra drums and just loop parts of the track. And this way you can even make like a remix of existing tracks. Vacación en Chile from Hilario Alicante. Thank you. use then, like if I don't have the samples of the track, I just use like loops from the original. Like for example here, you just have the melody playing, you can loop this. And then play the rest you want to add, you just play it on top. And super nice if you can just take things you really like, also a little part from it, and also something that's recognizable, and bring it in a completely new way, like the original track of Hilario Alcantara sound nothing like this. This is the original, like this is completely different, but still you have the special feeling and the connection with the original, and it's a lot of fun to do. So.
One thing left to do now. Go to the after party!